以国际的视角，全球的理念，解读新经济的运营之道。十四位理论扎实、实践丰富的国际专家，为您展示全新的经济世界。
节目非常有名。
来装回答，都说大家。
前年的实践和理论，
共同建筑我们的论坛。
敬请收看名家论坛推出的特别节目《中西实践家系列》。
各位名家论坛的观众朋友们，大家好，我是林伟贤，很高兴也很谢谢大家肯定我们，并且持续的收看我们《中西实践家》的系列节目。在名家论坛当中，我们帮你邀请到了很多的国际的专业人士，他们有来自于美国，来自于加拿大，来自于澳大利亚，来自于夏威夷，从各个不同的地方集合到我们名家论坛里面来，为的就是把世界带进中国，让中国领航世界。我们期望能够通过这样节目的播出，在全国各地的放送，可以协助更多的企业家在我们中国做好企业的同时，也能够以中国为基础为核心，能够走上创新的道路，并且迈向世界各地。我们为你邀请到的专家呢，都有非常丰富的实务经验，有非常棒的理论架构跟实际的系统。那么今天呢，我们为你所邀请到的这位呢，是来自于美国的 Declan 先生。那么他本身呢，是可以说是现在最重要的新兴的行业，实际上说新兴也不新兴了，可是做得好用得好的呢，却才是这个时代真正创业致富的关键。他的专长呢，是在网络方面 Internet。 所以呢，我们现在来看一段有关 Declan 先生的一个背景的介绍，请看这一段背景介绍。
德克兰·登先生是 Find Money Good Blog 互联网市场运作系统的创始人，此系统用于帮助全球各地的企业家们，其中一些企业比如 American Express 等。他擅长先于市场洞察网络生意的趋势，针对在线顾客的需求做出最大利益化的策略，注重通过电子邮件来与顾客创造商业关系。他著有《做合作游戏的赢家》《网络利润》等。自1986年以来，他一直都是硅谷的资深拓展专家。
好的，我想从背景介绍里面呢，我们都已经认识到 Declan 先生在这个 Internet 网络方面呢，是一个非常非常重要的专家。那首先非常欢迎你来到我们的节目 ，Welcome to the TV show here.
Thank you very much. Glad to be here.
我很荣幸可以访问到您。那我们知道，其实现在全世界的人已经都无法想象没有 Internet 的世界了，对吗？这世界变得这么快，什么是最大的改变？在这几十年来，从没有网络到有网络，how to change the people's life， 怎么改变了我们人类的生活
？Well, the big difference with the internet is it's connecting people. It's the first media that's allowed people to actually communicate back to them. And that what changes is it allows people to give feedback, and businesses have to learn to listen. Because in the old ways, we only had media that was always talking. I like to say at them rather than with them. And having a dialogue. So what changed was, instead of having TV, radio, magazines, which are all fine, but always talk, you know, and have to talk at you and hope the customer goes somewhere else, in the internet, right where they are, talking with them is where we have the action taken and where we have to listen to them.
Yeah, so that's a key point. 这是最重要的关键。我想很多的大老板他会很担心说，哦，我现在不敢用这个，因为任何一个新的产品被发明，电视被发明，广播被发明，电脑被发明，网络被发明的时候，刚开始都有一些恐惧感。所以对那些大老板来讲，他怎么克服这样的恐惧，对于使用网络？
Well, to overcome the fear of the internet, you basically have to find a way to integrate it with the other media, because unlike the other media stand alone, the internet is where they go after they see TV, after they listen to radio, after they see magazines. It's where they go to find more information. So the thing is not to fear it, but to embrace it and understand that it gives you a more automated way to be in continual contact with people, which scares some companies first, but actually in the end will turn out to add a lot of profit to the bottom line.
他们说那些在学校小学里面使用电脑的小学生的人数比全世界的 CEO 使用的电脑的人数的比例还要高，他们不太习惯使用这样的东西。
No, they're not, but one of the things they should do is because their children are being raised with it, which is one of the first fears. My children are better than me.
Yeah.
Which is not necessarily true, because what the smart CEOs do is they watch their children and then they start learning, this isn't such a big deal. I can find the way to use it for myself and the way people will use it to make their lives easier.
开始去学还有机会。
Yeah. And not to expect to understand it immediately, because it is different in the way that we interact with our customers, but it's not rocket science, as I like to say.
我想现在很多人他们都以前用的少嘛，现在很多人都已经开始上网站啊，然后把公司放上去啊，然后甚至在地方买卖啊等等啊。那现在有的人个人都有很多网站，或者公司有很多的网站，你怎么样在这么多网站里面可以让人家看到你、发现你、一眼就注意到你 ？How to？
Well, the first thing, most people start with a website.I suggest you start with the customer and start acting like the customer. What I mean is sit in front of a computer for a week and have other people and research and look at your competition, because most people create a website like an island. Yeah. You can find out everything your competition's doing and then do it better, because otherwise you're going blind. You're flying blind. Oh, I buy from them. I buy from them. I sign up. I experience. I want to know as the customer what they're doing, because I can find ways to add profit.By seeing what my competitors are doing, you'll find one or two do it right and about 10 or 20 do it wrong. And you want to be the one or two doing it right. Watch what's already out there and then improve upon it, because your customer is comparing you to all those other people.
Yeah, 所以我们刚刚在问他说，那你用这个方式的话，等于说你从你竞争对手上面学到最多的东西嘛，因为竞争对手上面什么东西都有啊，所以我们可以从那上面把它看得很清楚，就可以跟他购买。可是有时候会不会有一种情况，就是说 ，Internet 当然非常好，我们也希望能够在上面放了最多的资讯，让大家可以看到最多的内容。那有时候呢，会不会因为这样子，所以你公司的这个商业机密也可能会被拿走呢 ？OK。
Well, now that's a very good point. Number one, don't put your commercial secrets on the
internet. 不要把商业机密放上去。
Boeing actually did that in the early days.
But if you have new products, 如果你有一个新产品，你会 put on internet， 会把它放上去啊。
Well, if you have products you're putting on the internet, you want to put them out. And if you really have a secret, then you shouldn't put it on the internet. But if selling your products is a secret, yes, your competition is going to see what you do, replicate it.And then you got to keep doing it better. It's part of the race.
Yeah, 有很多的人其实现在很多年轻人进入公司，他们比以前厉害很多很多、啊。那我们现在公司不仅有外部网站，还有内部网站嘛。那内部网站就像我的公司，几乎会把大部分的资讯都放上去，放在网络上，让人家可以看到。那这些人他就很容易可以把公司内部的资讯都拿出去了。所以应该怎么避免这样的情况发生 ？How to avoid?
Well, how to avoid it is first establish what information you obviously want to share. And if you want to keep that offline, the best thing is to keep it totally separate and only open to your employees.
Yeah, indeed, we open for them.
A firewall. Open, But other than that, it's not to be so afraid of what you put on there, because it's an odd thing, but you can't control it. And by trying to control it, now you can control what you put on there, yes. But if you're worried about everybody copying you and things,you're going to have a problem, because it's going to happen, and it's because the marketing can be copied and replicated, but your message, your product to your audience is something that shouldn't be easily stolen by your competition. Well, the first step to doing something on the internet is to really take a little time to look what's out there and to first find where is your customer comfortable buying your product or service. If it's in the real world, then we want to get an inquiry.Get them either on the phone or in person and meet them in the real world. If we can sell it online, like computers right now are very easy, then we want to know how to put a very smart web page focused on one product per, when somebody goes in, focus them on the product they want to buy, not on choices, not on 100 choices that they might buy.
所以以我们这样来讲，要开始的时候等于说不是从很大的地方开始。That's only one product first, 一个产品开始嘛。Or maybe we can have a website and then the same kind of product. 还是有一个网站有同类的产品的。
You can do more than one product, but the most important thing is you want to get contact with your customer. Don't expect them to come back to your website. Assume they're going to be there for 30 seconds. How in 30 seconds can you convince them to either buy your product or to leave their name, their phone number, their email address, what have you, to further follow up on the inquiry?
什么会更重要呢？让他们买东西还是让他们留资讯？
Well, if you're talking about retail, it's about buying a product. They're going to buy it online. But I find that most often, it's more important to have them leave their information, because even in marketing, it teaches us 2-5% of the people buy. It means 95% don't.
在台湾这个比例还更高。我们送10万份电子邮件出去，就10个人会给你回复。那 percentage is very low.
Well, the percentage
比例很高，比例很低。Yeah.
The percentage is low, but the other thing is the cost is very low too, and you have to learn. Yeah. And if you're good, they'll come back.
Yeah.
But your website experience, this is why you have to look at your competition. If you don't see, because your customer is going to compare you, and there's companies that do it right, but most make it horribly hard to just buy a product. And that's the game. Make it easy.
Yeah. Yeah. 我想这个是一个很重要的关键。我想很多人最大的问题是，就是说，我想这个网站，我只用我自己的方法去想，啊，我做成这样很漂亮。但是实际上在做的时候，那可能你没有去做过市场调查，你可能没有了解你的竞争对手在做什么，所以做得很困难。对，如果把梦想跟现实可以实际把它拉在一起。
Maybe your website's not a work of art; it's a work of business. And to have it work, there's certain principles like putting things on the right-hand side of the screen, which is when you scroll down, that's where you go. That's the hottest part of the screen for creating commerce. Little things like that and allowing your customer to quickly, within 2 or 3 clicks, to get to the product or service they want to buy. If you make it longer than that, you'll lose them.
Yeah, 按照你的经验来讲，只有30秒钟他们会停留在那个地方。So how to attract their eyes? 怎么吸引他们眼球呢？
Yes.Well, first, it's your copy, it's your words, it's your asking them and getting them curious to explore further. Now, if you're a bigger brand, you might get a longer stay because people are familiar with your brand. Big brands have a big advantage there. But the real key is, when they come there, I ask you, what is, for you, the business? What's the single most important action you'd like the customer to take? And you focus that. So you could have a web page, but if on the right-hand side, in fact, we've tested a little yellow, light yellow background,you put some inquiry there, their eyes go right there. Because remember, computers have been around a long time, and it's about their behavior on the computer as much as your website and where they go. And that's not, it's right-hand side is really where you want to put those action items.
So, 现在好像是触碰经济，有一个东西在那个闪啊闪啊，你就会去碰它。我有时候到网站上面看，这边在闪，那边在闪，不不不不，你不知道要点哪一个。So, what's better? 什么样会好一点？
Simple, simple.Do as little as possible on that entry page because what you're doing is making them think so much and they're not that interested in thinking. They want to find what they want. So many people who start a website sit down with their webmaster and go, oh, let me think of everything they could want. What I want you to think about is really they're only going to be there for 2 or 3 specific reasons for most businesses. Make sure that that's clear and that it's identified and that it says it to them in the right words.And in the right invitation. And plus, what we do is we give them a reward. Do this action, and I'll give you an audio online, or an ebook, or a discount, or a coupon. You've got to incentivize them to take action.
Uh-huh. 以国际的视角，全球的理念，解读新经济的运营之道。14位理论扎实、实践丰富的国际专家，为您展示全新的经济世界。
节目非常有名。
来往回答，都说大家。
前年的实践和理论，
共同建筑我们的论坛。
12本书，我出了8套的光碟。如果以我来讲的话，我把这12本书跟8套光碟放到网络上面去的时候，我是放在一起呢，在同一个网站呢，还是 separate？不同的网站 ，separate website or the same website?
Actually, the answer is both. We'd actually use one website to have everything and then have separate websites for those individual products that we drive to make them buy just that product. So, for instance, if you're on a search engine and you buy a per-click ad, when they click on that, send them to one book. If you send them to your homepage with all those books, it will be a little bit more difficult because they're making 12 choices and it's not that easy. But best recommendation is,Think of 2 or 3 products, what we call a lead product, the first purchase. Focus them on that and then bundle your other products so after they buy once, which is the real key, getting them to buy the first time. Once you do that, all those other products become far easier to sell.
就像我写了一本书叫《创新中国》。那如果以你的建议来讲的话，我到网站上面去的时候，是不是就是只有写个创新中国点公司，然后就到网站里面去，只有看到我创新中国这本书，没有其他东西。Is that right?
Yes, it really is. It will improve greatly your sales. And then you can lead them into your bigger website with all those other products because they'll get to know you through Innovative China. And after they buy, by the way, there's a thank you page. You know, thank you for buying. Uh-huh. Send them to your other products and books or put your other books on your order form. Because what's interesting is if they buy your one book, you may say, hey, if you like that, you can buy this at the same time because then they're already ready to order. They're in the checkout stand.
Yeah.
And that's the good place to put more products on. That's where they're more receptive.
Yeah, so I think that's very important for the thank you page.
Yes.
Yeah, 我想这个很重要，就有关于一个谢谢的这个页面啊，因为所以我有时候网络上买东西的时候，哎，买完之后他会给你一个谢谢的页面，说啊谢谢你购买，可是并没有推销我其他东西。所以你认为这是最好的方法吗？ 在网络上，每当他买了一个东西的时候，立刻就告诉他你再买一个东西，那会不会觉得说我才刚赚到，你才刚赚到我的钱，马上又赚到我的钱呢 ？So you mentioned about the thank you page, right? So but if you really put the other, you know, information on the thank you page, and maybe the consumer will think, oh, cheers, you just make my money, and now you want to want me to pay for another money, you want to sell me another thing, is that good?
Well, again, we need to test it. In some cases, yes, definitely yes. Uh-huh. In fact, if they're actually at the thank you page and they resent you offering more products, you have a problem because you haven't really convinced them. And it doesn't mean you have to sell them there, but the question is, what's really amazing is, what do they do next? Because they just gave you their money. What we found is that's a very good place to upsell or cross-sell them. And if the market doesn't appreciate that, if they're very anti you upselling them,then send them someplace where you give them another bonus or another gift. Keep them in your website, your world. That's the key, because what happens, they just bought, where do they go next?
Yeah, so I think that this is the key point I want to understand there. You know, because there are many people, they just go to website, and when you go to there, some website, they say, okay, you are the number 10,001 people to the website. Another time, they say, okay, you are the number 200,006 to get on the website.Do you think it's good or not to put a number? 有时候你到网站上会说你是第几号来这边参观，这样做好吗？ It's good or not?
It doesn't make sense. I mean, when I go in a store, do they say you're the 100,000th customer? No, because that actually makes me, in a way, feel smaller. I don't want to know I'm one of 100,000. I want to know I'm unique and I'm the one. I don't believe in putting the numbers on there. Read the numbers in your back, you know, in your own office, and use those numbers. But frankly, when you do that, it's almost like you're bragging about that, how many people you have.I mean, a store doesn't sit there and say, we had 10,000 people come in yesterday. They sell products. It's about putting them in the focus of the product, not, ooh, you have many visitors, because they should be impressed by your product or service, not the visitors.
Yeah, but that's another thing. If you say, okay, you are number 100,000, I will give you a gift, then you will care. Yeah, I'm the number 10,000, right? 所以如果说我就是第一万名了，第100,又第十万名，又第一万名进来，我有礼物，那我就会关心我是哪个号码。So,Could you just give them like an ID, right? 所以你让每个顾客都好像有一个身份证号码一样，那或许你这个身份证号码就可以在这个网络里面有一些礼物送给他啦，有一些价值给他，他就对他自己是几号就很重视了， right? If you can give them an ID number, and we also we can send them some gift, right?
Yes.
Then maybe the number will be meaningful. Otherwise, the number is no meaning, right?
If the number's not connected to business, what are you doing?In their mind, yes. If they're the 100,000 customer and there's a reward, yes, fantastic.
Yeah.
But if it doesn't connect to what your purpose is in business, because you keep thinking that the customer is going to be impressed, just think about you. What's going to impress them is keeping them focused and keeping them guided to where you want them to go.
Yeah. But for the China company here, it's very difficult in the first beginning, okay, to put on the internet, because we are Chinese reading.And we are Mandarin speaking, okay, so it's not easy for us to use English, just like myself, okay? It's very hard for me to interview you by English, but I'm trying my best. So how to overcome the language problem? 在中国我们其实大部分我们讲的是普通话，我们写的是中文，所以在网络上的话其实有很多英文的环境，所以对我们来讲其实有点困难，刚才讲用这么多不同的语言，所以在这网站上或者在 internet 上面应该怎么去克服这种语言的问题， how to overcome the language problem?
Well, the language problem, depending if you're going to a different culture or a different language, you might want to take your site and actually put it under a separate domain name for English, let's say, versus Mandarin.You can have a link in your site and have it translated, though translating, I would want to see that it was making money before I would go crazy translating everything over, because you have a certain market who wants to use your product or service. If you want to get beyond the language barrier, unfortunately, you want to really determine which languages you're going to reach, and most often, we'll actually create the same website, but put it, let's say, if I was coming to China, I would put under a .cn if I could, not...under a .com, which is a US domain name. I'm not sure if that's possible, but I would put it under a separate domain name so that they could understand this is the English and this is the Mandarin version.
Yeah, so that means, of course, we must do many things. We must translate everything into Chinese or translate everything into English, right? Yeah, but the key problem for some business here is, some company here, they are not so good at using English.So maybe we will lack of some opportunity to understand the information from outside. 所以有时候我们本地公司遇到的困难就是我们可能在英文的使用上比较不是那么多，不是那么好，所以我们可能会因此会缺乏一些资讯。Lack of information about English side.
Well, I mean, if you don't have information about using English, are you saying?
That means, there are so many English websites, right? And English information on internet. But we are Chinese reading, Chinese speaking.
Yeah.
So it's very hard to understand those other information.
Oh, I'm sure. And I find it very hard to understand a Mandarin site, totally.
Yeah.
The best thing you can do is often partner with somebody who does, obviously, speaks the language and also understands the marketing. If you want to get the words translated, that's a source. You can do that. But what's most important, because sometimes you'll find, for instance, in China, there would be different colors I've seen on websites that appeal to this culture as opposed to the US or Europe, UK, where I've seen other colors, styles work, because each country has its own style that works. And if you use a US style, wouldn't work very well.
Yeah.
And even beyond the language, you want to make sure that you have somebody who's fluent in it and can help you and understand both sides of it. So you're just saying, great, put my content in there and partner with them if you can.
照你的意见来讲，像我们是实践家，那我们有实践家点大陆，实践家点台湾，实践家点新加坡，实践家马来西亚，或实践家点公司，有的用在美国各个地方。那照你的专业意见来讲的话，我们在不同的国家或地区所使用的这个网站的这个首页，这个 homepage 应该是不一样的 ，different design.
Not totally different design. You take the design, but mostly it's an issue of color. And imagery, so you don't have to go crazy designing everything over.
Yeah.
You want to take it, but you might make it, like I would find some designs might not work in a certain culture. Then really what you're doing is tweaking maybe a few photographs and some colors, not the words, not the products, not that, just making it a little bit more friendly.
Just the way we present.
Yeah.
只是我们所表现的方式。
But the same website design, you know, don't reinvent the wheel.
Yeah, otherwise there will be a big job. 不然我的工作太浩大。
Yeah.
So you mean maybe just like China.Okay, China used to use the red color.
Yes.
Red one. And when you go there, you say, oh, that's China, be red China, right? So maybe when Taiwan, you go to there, you say the blue Taiwan or something like that. Maybe you have a special color. So what do you mean is we put a different picture, or we use a different color, more localized to make it more easier to get it. 就像你所建议，就比如说像我们在中国大陆，我们可能使用很多的红色啦，台湾地区可能使用很多的蓝色啦，然后比如说美国各种不同的颜色。所以如果我们在放一些不一样的图片或者不一样的颜色的时候，可能对他们来讲会更容易可以进来可以看得到。Is it?
Yeah, you want to make it more local, but definitely not redesigning everything. But try to look in the look, the color, and really often sometimes the language too. The way that you speak to a different audience.Can be very different, so you're just slightly changing it, but the basic design, the framework, stays the same. It's just the words and a little bit of the color might be different.
Yeah, okay. And so sometimes they think, you know, if when you go to internet, you want to create business in internet, that's free. Is that right? 很多人说你去网络做一个事业是不要钱的 Is that right?
Well, it's free, but free doesn't usually create business. Because if the free tends to get you what you pay for, and it doesn't mean you should pay too much, but I've never seen anyone who's done free do really, really, really well.
But in the end, it's low cost is possible. 低成本是可能。
It's so low cost to begin with. I mean, you don't want to go spend too much, but it's so low cost that it doesn't make sense to even do it for free.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't cost that much.
Yeah. But in the end, for those really big company, they just burn money. 但是对那些真的大的公司，他们烧了很多钱在上面。Is it?
Yeah, well, the bigger companies, they just jump into the internet, they go right to the website, and they start thinking about it, but they haven't even taken the time to look around.
Yeah.
And if they did, what they end up doing 6 to 12 months later is they look around and go, wait, this person's doing it much better than us.
Uh-huh.
If you did that before you went to the website for about a week, you would know so much on how to design the colors, the words, and it just means don't jump into the website and sit alone in your room. Go out to the internet a little bit,and play a little bit and watch what people do. Or even better, one of the best things is, bring in 5 or 10 people, students, people off the street, it doesn't matter. Sit them in front of a computer, in front of your website or your competitors, be quiet and watch them. Because you will see where they get lost, where they get confused, and I can tell you, you will learn how to avoid months worth of mistakes by just, and they don't even have to be your target customer. Because a computer is an interface. The way people use it is really scary, it's similar.Across people, across generations, it's the same. And it'll give you a lot of insight on what works and what doesn't.
Uh-huh. So that means maybe sometime we can think ourselves as a consumer, is it? So 有时候我们自己把它当作顾客 then we just double check with which website. If I'm a consumer, then go to my own homepage, which myself would like it or not. 有时候把自己当作顾客去看看自己会不会喜欢它 Is this also one of the way to test?
Yes, I recommend starting as a customer and thinking as a consumer. It's a little bit different because offline, you had to create the ad or the final product. You didn't have a chance to get the audience feedback for 3 or 6 months. online, we can get our feedback in 2 weeks. Yeah. So you really want to make sure that you think more about the consumer and their experience of using your website and how easy it is, where they get lost. For example, one of my clients had a music playing on their homepage. Uh-huh. So the person came in, clicked to a product, and then went back to the homepage. Well, the music was playing again. And I watched, and the person said, that song was nice. Uh-huh. They go back into the website, come back to the homepage, the song plays for a third time. They go, could you turn that song off?
Could you give me another song? You can give me another song, girl. Yeah. So I heard about Michael Dell. Okay. Michael Dell, he wrote the books, and he say he always go to their own website, to your computer, and just like a consumer to leave the information and just want to test, okay, the people how to, deal with this problem, okay? So just like a consumer and go to layer, didn't leave any name, because when you leave the name of Dell, then they know that's a boss. So just let a consumer to test the feedback about the engineer, or maybe for those technical people or those customer support team from the internet. That's the best way for the CEO to understand the control. 这是一个方法吗？因为戴尔电脑的老板，他经常这样做，他会到网络上面去，故意到自己的网站留一些资讯，留一些内容，看看他们的工程师，看他们的服务人员，看他们那些支持团队对这个东西的反馈跟回应是什么。你觉得这个方法怎么样？
Well, I think if you give it to an engineer thinks a certain way, and also is very familiar with it. I want to give it to a stranger, a consumer, who has no introduction, because then I get a real experience, because at home, they're in front of a screen. Yeah. No one's there to help them. And what's funny, even with Dell, they used to get about 50% of their orders over the phone. Yeah. Because even if they're good, the person said, wait, there's that one thing you couldn't give me. They always had a phone number for somebody to call. Yeah. And that's what made the sales go through. But if you don't deal with a consumer, like if you do with your webmasters and engineers, they think and they know, like the youth do, they know how to use the internet, and that almost biases them a little bit. I want no bias, I want raw, real experience, because that's what you're getting on the internet.
Yeah. There's one thing very interesting, I double check with many internet-based websites. When the company go to internet, just okay, you leave the email, okay, contact with me by email, then they leave the name of the company, but sometimes they just delete the address and the telephone number. So when I go to the website, I want to call the company, I cannot find out the telephone number. I can only email them. But for me, it's inconvenient for me to do that. So is that correct? You don't leave any address, or you just leave the email, you don't leave the telephone number? Many companies do that. Website. 很多公司你上去的时候，他说，我现在已经上网了，我就全部都上网了，我就只有留下 email, 电子邮箱，根本连地址跟电话都没有，这对吗？
That's a big mistake.
Okay, my gosh.
They can't even trust you. I mean, Why wouldn't you give them everything? We put their number prominently up there because the fact is, most people, when they start on the internet, they go, now we don't, this is all automated. No one has to contact us. The customer really, especially older customers, really want a phone number. Because they want to know if you're a real business, they'll call you, your address, your business. If you're embarrassed to do that, you're going to look a little bit not good.
Yeah. 我想或许有些时候他们是以为这个方法，我既然上网路就全部都网路。OK, so thank you being here. So we will talk more about this issue tomorrow. OK, so welcome to the show. 非常非常谢谢所有的观众朋友啊。那我想你今天对这个网路应该是打开你另外一扇不同的窗，从不同的观点跟我来做分享。这里是名家论坛的中西实践家。明天同一个时间，我们就要邀请 Declan 再跟我们来分享这方面有趣的跟有关的资讯。如果你希望跟全世界做生意，不能够错过明天的节目。名家论坛协助你透过中西时间家把世界带进中国，让中国领航世界。明天见，拜拜。Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.